tonight on Swords. A few captains are on the fish.
That's what we're here for. We aim to please.
Cha-ching.
But for others, it can't get any worse.
I'm trying to set gear in a fleet of boats. I don't know where I'm going.
We don't stand a chance.
One captain gambles her reputation.
They're going to lamp us right back out of the port.
And another risks his most valuable asset.
This is a nightmare waiting to happen.
It failed. It's over. It's done. Have to finish up the trip.
Grand Banks has definitely been the most discouraging season that I've had yet.
10 times more boats now than when we left.
While the Grand Banks has been a disaster, the coastal waters of Georgia's Bank continue to pay off for Captain Slick.
Well, I knew fishing was going to be good. I knew we'd do good once we got where we needed to be. I'm more than thrilled with the quality of our fish were. Wish we had a few more.
Now, with only days left to fish and the entire Grand Banks fleet muscling in on his home waters, the captain doesn't know if his prime spot will keep producing.
It's just too crowded up at home. I mean, just too many damn boats right now for us, and I just can't deal with that.
Kind of sucks when you're catching them this good and you run out of space.
Now it's like a mob sitting up there.
One of the boats crowding them out is the Eagle Eye 2.
Man, he's right up my ass, I guess, huh? Nah, they gotta pay attention. Here they go.
Come in, Scott.
Come in.
Yeah, putting everything out tonight?
Yeah.
Everything. We're just hoping we can
keep scratching enough to stay. Come in.
Yeah, Roger, yep.
Georgia's Bank is 150 miles long, but with only a few prime spots, it's shrinking by the minute.
Sucks. It just looks real fishy. It looks right. You know, and that's what we need right now.
Stupid people, boy. They ruined a perfectly good day.
Three hours later.
Morning. Nothing left to do now but drink coffee.
Still a bit dubious about all this water on the bank. Georgia seems to be affected a lot by the moon.
The late fall moon brings on higher tides and strong currents that attract big eye and yellowfin tuna, two of the most valued fish in the world. But it's not always a good sign.
Sometimes full moon is awesome, sometimes it's poison. Hopefully we see more big eyes, bigger big eyes, and make us happy.
Something's coming up on the line.
It's first foot. Okay.
Deckhand Tommy Fox uses the finesse of the live line in hopes of catching what they've been waiting for all season.
He's fighting hard.
Yes! Sushi!
The first fish of the day is a prized 100-pound big-eye tuna. This is the start the crew needs.
Another one for the good guys. Pat's acting like a tuna fish.
Hopefully it's Big Eye.
Show me another Big Eye. Easy, don't pull.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, man.
Nice fish.
Pretty fish.
And today we're catching mostly all Big Eye. And we got a little swordfish yet, but come on with the Big Eye.
Well, that's what we're here for. We aim to please.
Yeah!
That's a keeper.
Nailing this school of sushi-grade tuna is like hitting a jackpot.
Nice fish.
Ah.
Halfway through the gear, and Scotty's full moon set is paying off.
Big Eye, too, we always smile.
It's nice to get a good day of fishing. It brings everybody's morale up.
Fifty miles to the north, the mood is sobering on the Big Eye.
I'm very discouraged. For the last 48 hours, I've traveled over 275 miles, and I don't have a fish on the boat, nothing.
Late into the season, the crew of the Big Eye are still trying to scrape up a trip. And now, the captain hears a distress call over the radio.
Big Eye, Alex Murray, you on this one, Jobbers?
Yep, how you doing, Philip? What's up?
We're all wound up here in crab gear. Crab gear, lobster gear, we're wound up solid here. She's stolen the main engine radio.
Oh boy, dead in the water. Me, I see you there. I knew something was wrong. We're gonna come up and have a look, see what we can do. If we can help you out, or one way or the other. Not, we'll take you front power.
I cannot and I will not ride by a boat that's broke down and can't go in gear. It's dead in the water.
It's part of the fisherman's code. And out here, with the Coast Guard 24 hours away, Chompers is the only hope.
I wouldn't want it done to me, and I'm not going to do it to somebody else.
What's going on with Philip?
Philip's all messed up here. We're going to go through checking out.
You're not going to be able to fish.
The Big Eye descends on the paralyzed Alex Marine.
Boat, man. She's big as hell. Look at
it. Towing the Alex Marie in would cost Chomps time and money. Unless he can find a way to free the prop right now.
Woody, try it or not?
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yeah.
Get your wetsuit on, Woody, then.
You ready to go swimming?
Now listen to me now. Don't you go brain lock it on me. You hear me? Look at me.
Yeah.
We'll be going out and doing nothing I don't tell you to do.
Yeah,
go under there. You can't see. Come back out of there.
Yes, I know.
But don't do it, stupid. Don't even try to be no hero. Don't go in. There's no telling.
Steel hull of the Alex Marie.
This is a nightmare waiting to happen.
The boat rises up and drops back down in the seas, it'll hit you while you're under the boat and you up.
That's a big boat to come down on you. Steel hull hits you in the head when it drops. It's got to crush your skull underwater. You're stuck. Nobody has any idea.
After a few minutes in near freezing water, Woody was able to free the pot, but unable to cut the rope from the prop.
Go jump in the shower right with that wetsuit. Go jump right in that shower with that wetsuit. Go right on in there. Go right on in there. Come on. Come on. Woody, come on. Come on. Run. There you go.
The trout would have cut that out, but it's about 100 feet of rope wrapped around the wheel. The sea's duck. He tried to crank it up three more times and kept cutting off, so we're going to have to tow him in. Not real smart to be towing a bigger boat. Yeah, we have no cleats either.
We broke both our tie-up cleats in this first storm.
During Hurricane Igor, the Big Eye lost the only hardware it had to safely tow a boat.
that time up to them poles back there.
That'd be a nightmare.
Get me at both ends right there. You know what I mean? I'm gonna tie it, double it up, tie a cradle around it.
Twice the size of the big eye. Definitely grabbing the pole by the horns.
Always want to help your fellow fishermen out. Nobody wants to be stranded.
I take this knot so she ties like that, so all the pressure pulls around this rail right here.
The harness is nothing more than a chain of inch-thick rope.
We ain't quite rigged up like it should be.
Need more rope. It's so close to us, you know, the rope could pop. It's definitely not good on this boat.
That ain't gonna last. It's gonna wear out.
Miles from Newfoundland, the Hannah Bowden is one of the last boats standing on the Grand Banks.
It is October, we're on the Grand Banks, you gotta expect some bad weather. We've been awful lucky. I think our luck just ran out. Shark!
Blue sharks and bad weather are a painful combination for the crew. And it's making them question their captain's decision.
Just getting close to the end of the season. Fish are leaving. That's why everybody else is left. And
lots of sharks, heavy sharks.
I'm not the sharpest knife in the drawer, but if you were to look around, you'd have a pretty good indication that it's over, you know? I think we're all feeling about the same right now, you know. As far as going to George's, I'd have to say any place is better than here right now.
The dismal day is finally over.
Pretty much getting on this day, so we'll see what the plan is.
But Linda is not ready to quit.
No, there's still, you know, one or two things I need to try out here before I throw the towel in. So we're hanging out.
The captain calls her crew to get them up to speed on her final choice.
Kind of nice to have everybody up here once we can all be on the same page. I know the fishing's been really slow, and tonight's the first quarter. It's really kind of too late for us to bail and go to George's, so I'm absolutely committed to staying here. And just so you know, I'm not discouraged about the fishing. I mean, I know it sucks, and I really appreciate your number one, hard work, and number two, good attitudes about it, because I mean, we're all in the same boat, literally and figuratively. It sucks, but we're here, so we'll make the best of it. Thanks, guys. It's not easy to make decisions about, you know, where to fish and when to fish and how to fish. But, you know, it's part of being a captain. The most difficult part about making those decisions is my decisions really determine the livelihoods of everyone on this boat.
For the crew, it's unanimous. It's time to leave the Grand Banks. But the captain makes the final call.
Be interested to see how it plays out, I guess.
You know, for this adventure, I didn't make out the way that I had hoped to this year. Definitely sacrificed some finances to come out here.
Imagine they're all probably ready to go home.
I'm ready.
For a long trip.
A 1,000 miles southwest, off the coast of Massachusetts. The big guy is towing the paralyzed Alex Marie.
Got a disabled fishing vessel in tow on a northwest course. Any concern traffic count 16 and 10. Big eye out.
Now I'm in the process of towing a 160-ton fishing vessel, more than twice the size of the big eye. And we're not moving real fast, but we're paddling hard.
The captain had no choice in saving this fallen longliner. But every mile steaming to port has put the big guy deeper into debt.
It's costing me money and time.
whatever. It is what it is. See me here, let up.
Yeah.
We'll see you in a few.
Roger, Roger.
Finally, Chomps is ready to turn the Alex Marie over to the New Bedford pilot boat.
Good morning, Tommy. Maybe you can slip around my port stern corner there and grab these guys.
Okay, I'm just by the first set of buoys outside the lighthouse.
Alex Marie, I got.
Yeah, we're clear here, Chomp.
Good, good, good.
Things wouldn't be too good with those other fishermen. People say a lot of things about fishermen, but most of us are half decent and we look after each other. You depend on your other fellow fishermen when you're broke down to tow you in, and they depend on you.
Okay, man, thanks a lot.
No problem. No problem at all.
Hopefully we can get out there and find some fish.
Can't that be luckier?
Yep. It's always darkest before the dawn, so hopefully things will get better.
Miles south, Captain Slicks finally found a spot where he can fish.
I hope we don't get jinxed. I hope tonight, you know, we get out that extra 10 miles of gear, those extra 400 hooks, and I hope it pays off.
Moving east has given Slick more space, but he's unsure this new spot will produce and starting to feel the pressure.
I'm not just worried about putting weight on the fish, we're worried about putting quality on the boat right now, so.
The captain's stress is shared on deck as the crew sets out the most important 40 miles of line all season.
Three pieces of bait, first swim.
I got one more bag of bait actually.
Keep on going. Is this it, Charmer? Huh? Is this gonna be it?
Nope.
Really?
Really?
I told you we're set it
all. Every hook set is a chance to catch big fish, and Slick's plan is to gamble it all. But Greenhorn Butters didn't anticipate the captain's ambitious tactics.
Get a different amount of gear almost every night. So you never know, it's a crapshoot in the Slick. Best be safe and I guess get enough bait out for every piece of gear we got, but Slick doesn't like bait sitting around, so some days I feel like I should be a mind reader on this boat.
Bait, come on.
The boat.
Butter's inexperience shows as he struggles to keep up with the hectic pace.
I mean, I told him with over a section to go that we're setting everything on the boat. He had more than sufficient amount of time to throw out bait for the whole set, more than enough time.
Now we're scrambling.
Now we're really scrambling.
This is
you guys know, I told Butters, before this section, we're setting everything out.
There's no way. There's no way.
Pick it up, Butters! Don't you let us down!
It takes hours to properly defrost bait. But Butters only has minutes to keep the rest of the crew working.
Trying to defrost bait. Trying to get some thawed out real quick. Don't have enough bait for it.
Here. No fish! No fish!
What are we doing? We cannot catch a fish without bait.
Okay.
Right now, we're on standby. Butters has stopped the boat.
Rookie, just so you know, we failed as a team, man.
I got two more things to bait out.
Yeah, well, it wasn't enough.
Wasn't enough, man.
Slick wanted 400 hooks in the water, but with no more bait ready, 340 is all he gets.
Ready? You didn't turn a strobe on.
Then.
No strobe.
Butters knows all too well that when failures pile up, Captain Slick can go one of two ways.
You didn't pull when I'm
angry.
With you the
or crazy.
You
he's got flower pots.
Yeah! Woohoo!
Come on! Who's a jackass? He's a jackass. Wouldn't want to be on to be a jackass. Butters! Where's the beeper with no strobe on it? I can't see it because it's not what? It's not what? Blasted!
Slick's rule is if you forget to turn the strobe on, throw the last beeper out, you owe him $100.
$100 beeper in here. Flash, where's flash.
She's strobing now.
The butter is not good under pressure whatsoever. Totally falls on his face and flounders. It's a high stress job, high stress area. Hopefully butter does better tomorrow than tonight.
Tomorrow's another night, keep on trucking.
Miles off the coast of Newfoundland is the Hannah Bowden.
I'm not ready to throw the towel in. This is all part of what we call fishing. Part of it is hunting. And the longer the hunt goes on unsuccessfully, you know, you do get down, you do get discouraged, but it's not easy.
Alone on the Grand Banks and with no money coming aboard, Linda knows her decision to stay is impacting the crew.
She's the dictator, so what she says goes. Just suck up and deal and hope for better days.
The crew is very good natured. I have a great crew here, but things are looking pretty dire right now in the terms of paychecks.
The fall season is coming to an end, and the crew is giving up hope on making money. Now, they just want to break even.
I think we need around 20,000 to pay for expenses. Then that's when we start making a little bit of money for ourselves. I don't believe you're going to see that happen.
Everybody's giving up hope on making a huge paycheck. Never caught any fish yet. I don't think we're going to catch any.
Your wife wants to hand your wife a check or something. There's nothing there. Sometimes they don't understand, you know? That's going to be a tough part.
Yeah, and they're going to laugh us right back out of the port.
Here it comes.
Well, that's it. See what happens tomorrow. Tomorrow will tell the tale.
These 200 hooks in the water will either dig them deeper into debt or help them break even. Either way, Linda's reputation is on the line.
It's called job security. Do I want to take this boat again next season? You're damn right I do. Am I going to be able to if I don't put fish on the boat? Don't know.
Miles southwest is the Francis Ann.
Ran out of bait last night, wasn't too pleased with that. Still had a mile or two to go, but once again, butters. So we'll see what we have on the gear here today.
First beeper of the morning here. Hopefully it's loaded with fish.
Because of Greenhorn Butters' mistake, the crew sets 60 less hooks than Slick wanted to.
Things were a little slow and shaky this morning.
This late in the season, those 60 hooks could make all the difference.
Maybe a little spread out in this game.
Oh, I understand completely. It's embarrassing. They have 4.5 hours to set out, and you still run out of bait.
For the Greenhorn, it's a no-win situation. If they land on the fish, it's Butter's fault they didn't catch more.
Come on, man!
And if they don't, well, that's Butter's fault, too.
Come on! Big sword, yeah. She's a marker. Good morning, marker.
Nice fish, come on.
Woo! Yeah. Come on. Come on.
Come on, baby.
Come on.
This 150-pound marker swordfish is a solid start.
See, Butters? If you didn't run out of bait, we probably would have caught another one.
Butters in the doghouse. Awesome.
Feel some weight here.
Get that gaff ready, Butters.
Get this started. Nice tuna. Yeah.
Woo! That's right. What's up.
Good morning, man. Good morning.
That's how you start the morning right.
A marker and a marker, big eye.
Cha-ching.
120-pound big eye, 130, 140-pound swordfish. Come on.
That's what I'm talking about. Don't be too excited. She never ran out of bait.
Oh, my God, Butter. She really f***ed us last night.
If we would have had some more bait out, we could have doubled that.
Yeah, I'm going to take a piece all day.
Good job!
Big, big eye on the line.
Here we go.
Come on!
Yeah. Swordfish.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yes, slick.
Come on.
Watch the plane.
That's why I love fishing right there. Catching fish like that. Big marker swords and big eyes. That's what it's all about.
What, that one, Mac? Come on! $10,000 worth of fish already today. $10,000 worth of fish. Come on, what's better than that?
We haven't even got the first beeper in yet.
On a sword boat, a deckload of fish means all is forgiven.
Yeah, way to go, Butter.
Rookie!
Coming up, Captain Chompers goes it alone.
I'm trying to set gear and flee the boat. I don't know where I'm going. I'm panicking.
Miles south of New Bedford, Massachusetts, the Big Eye is finally reaching the edge of the fishing grounds.
I'm panicking a little bit, not making a dime.
Rescuing the Alex Marie has cost the Big Eye valuable time. Now, Captain Chomps hasn't gotten his hooks wet in 2 weeks. And to make matters worse, Chomps hears news that Captain Scotty and Slick have hit the jackpot.
You guys should have had a big head count. At least 30 anyway.
Save me some of them big eyes, you know. Steaming around the goddarn ocean. Catching all the big eyes, you sorry.
Yeah, we're doing all right. Couple good days, 25 big eye days.
Maybe troll around or maybe you'll catch one.
As night falls, the crew grabs some much-needed rest. But the man in the wheelhouse is grinding his way back to the fishing grounds.
Oh, man, the fishing here is insane. I've never caught so many tuna. Two fish all day long. Catch
them. As other captains hit the mother load, Chomps can't wait any longer to take his share. There are fish out there, and Chomps wants them. So he starts setting out by himself.
Man, that's f***ed up. That's f***ed up as hell.
Making our first set.
Oh, come on.
Realizing their captain is out there, the crew scrambles on deck.
Everybody's head's kind of out there right now, so we really got to kind of buckle down and get focused.
Both of them right here.
I walked for 3 minutes.
It's like I told you to be doing with the ass stuff down.
We got to set out unexpectedly tonight, so it's a little bit more chaos than normal. Kind of behind the eight ball getting ready.
As the crew takes over, Chomps heads back to the wheelhouse.
Trying to set gear in a fleet of boats. I don't know where I'm going.
We need to get this going, get some fish on this boat, and get home.
Jump started, put the basket, the sat buoy, all right.
It's in the water.
200 hooks are now in the water, and Chomps can finally exhale.
can't catch fish unless your gear's in the water. If your gear ain't in the water, you can't catch fish. So we're gonna try it.
Three 300 miles off the coast of Newfoundland is the Hannah Bowden, the only boat left on the Grand Banks.
Set shot off the down the set.
We ready to pick up our end beeper. Start the day. Swordfish.
This is haulback number 6. It's kind of make or break day. We really need to have 1,000 pounds or better in order to stay here.
Despite the warning signs, Captain Linda Greenlaw is convinced her decision to stay will prevail.
Probably prolong the inevitable, and that is to make a move. But we'll see.
It's been days since the crew have seen a fish, and they aren't expecting it to get any better.
At this point, I don't give a We either catch what we catch or, you know, I'm not stupid. I ain't gonna get rich off this trip. Around this boat, has anybody seen that enthusiasm?
Now it's time to see if the Grand Banks has anything left to offer and whether Linda still has what it takes. Halfway through the set, and it's clear, the fish aren't here. And Captain Linda can't deny the Grand Banks season is over.
If the fish were here and going to bite, they would have bitten last night. Should I have left, you know, before the bad weather? Well, I didn't. And it cost me, so now here I am, we gotta try this, and now it's the third night. I could have been, you know, most of the way to George's by now. But if I'd done that, I probably really would have regretted not trying it here one more time. So either way, I'd have been saying I wish I'd done something different, I think.
Coming up, it's make or break time on the Big Eye.
Oh, big fish!
Getting ready to dive!
150 miles off the coast of New Jersey is the Eagle Eye 2.
Yeah!
Captain Scotty's decision to move south
fish on
is paying off on George's Banks.
There we go.
Getting some nice big eyes, pretty little yellowfin. We're all pretty happy with where things are going.
Is it a bar?
Yeah.
With his hold filling up, Scotty's already looking to next year.
Since I've been a little kid, my dad and I have always hunted and fished together, and I'm a real strong believer in you have to leave stuff for the following season. Well, I just try to do everything in my power. Practice as you preach.
Now, he's taking his philosophy on conservation even further and is part of a program to tag fish with PSAT tags, high-tech microchips that transmit right to a lab via satellite.
I feel that the data would be more valuable to me than the fish itself. This will help both the scientists and us. Tuna fish.
Tuna!
Yellowfin.
Yellowfin!
To ensure the fish stays healthy, the crew must gently net the tuna and keep water constantly flowing on deck.
You got him. You got him. Now, Tuya's, pull him up. You put that deck hose in his mouth, keep the deck wet. Okay.
All right, we got to get the net off. Got to pull him out of the net. Quick, 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 quick. Okay, there you go, nice and easy.
They have to keep the fish alive, and every second counts.
His mouth. Yeah, there you go, just a little bit. 58-148. Now put the tag in him right here. Okay, overboard, 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 overboard. Tagged him up, and he's off and swimming. First one of the trip. Awesome.
Swordfish guys, we don't only kill fish. We study fish too, so.
For our first fish, everything went perfect. I think we're gonna get a lot of data out of it. Happy to have one PSAT gone. Looking forward to getting three more out today.
150 miles southwest is the Big Eye. With hooks in the water and 4 hours rest, Captain Chomps is determined to put his bad luck behind him and land a trip.
It's easy to be weak at this time of year. Just go in and say heck with it. I'll be happy once I get my expenses. I'm so far away from right now, it ain't fun.
Every day's a new day.
Yeah, we're ready for some good fishing. A little change in our luck. We haven't had the best luck last month. It's a new trip, feeling good.
As they begin to haul, even Chomps is surprised at what's on the line. A good omen for the captain and his crew.
Chompers has got a bird up here on his shoulder. They must like mean people. Huh, Chomp?
Yeah, that's right. Mother Nature's got a funny way of acting.
He's just jealous because he ain't over here on you.
Oh, big fish!
Got big eye right there.
Break them off, Johnny. Don't break them off.
It's worth some money, man. You got to have him on the boat.
The fish hold has been empty for days, and losing this fish is not an option.
Be careful.
Pull against him as hard as you want to, but I ain't gonna do nothing but pull the hook out. That fish is gone.
That's why I don't.
The first fish on George's bank is a Big Eye tuna worth over $1,000.
About time we started catching something where our luck needed to change. Maybe towing that boat in helped us, I hope so.
Fish on.
The flat, broke crew would take any fish, but these sushi-grade tuna means there's still hope for payday. With only 10 days left, big money fish are at the end of the hooks, and it looks like this motley crew has finally hit their stride.
We did not have this good on every set at the Grand Banks. We made a trip. At least this looks promising, you know. If we can get us a good few five sets in here catching like this, it'll be all worth the while.
Days haul back, it was not grand, but it was some sort of income coming on the deck of this boat, which we really needed.
Finally, with weight in the hold, the promise of better days lie ahead for the captain.
Hopefully we can come out ahead if we can get a few good days of this nice fish and come back. I'm home. Home sweet home.
Next.
Another one.
For the Hannah Bowden, everything's coming up sharks.
I wouldn't wish this on my worst enemy.
Not good.
After today's hauls, the Francis Ann retakes the lead from the Eagle Eye, and the Hannah Bowden continues to fall behind while the Big Eye gains a little ground. 300 miles from Newfoundland, Captain Linda continues to pay greatly for her decision to stay on the Grand Banks.
Jack! This is dismal. This is like the worst ever. We've been fighting these blue sharks all season. I think they just won the battle. Nothing else is working for me today. Chewing up the gear. Not good.
If swordfish were on the ends of these hooks, the crew would be on their way to a record haul. But with a barrage of worthless fish, that's not going to happen anytime soon.
I'd rather go to my mother's funeral and do another trip like this one.
I think everybody here is ready to get back, you know. We've been on this boat steady the last 2 months straight. Everybody misses their family. Everybody wants to go home. Counting the days down. Everybody's got a little tally mark in their belt, just like prison.
Comes the Embuie. Welcome sight today. It's the one we've been looking for. End of a disastrous day. Couldn't come soon enough.
Bruised and battered, the crew hauls in the final beeper.
Well, I think we just hauled our last piece of gear off the Grand Banks for the 2010 season, I believe.
Don't get the bait up. Looks like we're out of here. I mean, the water's gone, the fish are apparently gone, the boats are all gone. Looks like we're gonna get out of here. All right, I'll get steaming. Thank you. Good job, guys.
Pretty grim overall. This is a kind of a last-ditch effort for us to see if we can pull something out of our hat. We've got 5 days steam ahead of us, try another spot.
Not happy about the results. You really wanted to finish strong. You know, this is a trip, you know, it would have taken to finish the season strong, and I'm not doing it.
Trying to put a bad decision to stay on the Grand Banks behind her, Captain Linda steams to George's Bank, hoping there's still a few fish left.
I hate George's. I don't want to go to George's, but I have to do what I have to do. I have a responsibility to do everything I can to get a trip aboard this boat. The water's gone, the fish are gone, the boats are gone, and we are going.